black girl called Claudette Colvin, born in 1939 in Birmingham, United States. She studied at Booker T. Washington in Montgomery, a night school reserved to the black community. In 1942, a pal of a school, Jerima Reed, is accused to have raped a girl. After that, he is condemned to the electric chair. Claudette was devastated, and it's at this moment that the hunger began. Thanks to a literature teacher, Claudette learned about the American black story, and mostly, she pushed her students to act for the black rights but reminded them that they have to be proud of the color of their skin, not invite the white people, especially for the girl. The second March 1945, like usually, Claudette took the bus to come back to her home at King Hill, a poor background. She sat with a friend of her at the back behind the colored sign. Two other friends are seated at the other side of the bus. The bus filled itself after each bus station, but some seats still available at the front of the bus. But a white woman wanted a seat while Claudette and her friend are seated. While at this moment already, a law said in the favor of the Afro-American that you don't have to let your seats for white people if some seat for them still free in that section. But the bus driver in the South always did like they wanted to, and by this way broke the law. So, to come back to Colette and this woman, even if the driver yelled at her to stand up and told her that he going to call the police, her classmate moved, but not her. Until, by force, two policemen get her out of the bus. At the same time, she screamed that it is a constitutional right. She is arrested, incarcerated, terrified. She quietly hoped in the prison that anyone could help her. And her wish was realized when the black activists heard the news and decided to support her. Her grind during two tough trials, where she was the first black to plead not guilty, and by the boycott of the bus, which started after her arrestation. In November 1946, by speech, and the 20 December of 1946, officially, the segregation in the bus is declared not constitutional. Unfortunately, the 50 girls stay in the shadow of Rosa Parks and Martin Luther King, but never a such advance on the black history would be possible without her, and these two iconic figures would have been who they are without Claudette Colvin.